East Travis Street, then turn right onto Avenue E.
No iba a caer. No te voy a sacar, papi.
Ha, ha, ha. maybe down here. All right, welcome to Go Rio Cruises. My name is Hannah. I will be your captain tonight. Are we having a good time in San Antonio so far? Enjoy this. Did y'all, we're out here for fiesta. A little bit. It's kind of fun.
Well, before we get started,
I just want to go over some safety rules. You can check on your seats for those seatbelts. Ties up really tight. It's going to be a bumpy ride.
We don't have any seatbelts.
I know, there aren't any seatbelts. I couldn't get past it. Well, but if you can still please stay seated. There's a lot of low bridges and they hurt when you hit them.
So what's up?
Please keep everything inside the boat, including your children. Don't try to reach the bridge or the ramp or the duck. This is a non-smoking boat, including electronic cigarettes and vaping. Please try and keep all side conversations at a smaller, lower volume. Out of respect for the other guests on board. And if we happen to hit an iceberg and we all fall out, I do have life jackets for each and every one of you. It would be easier on me though if you just stood up after and just give me a better target to throw the life jackets at. Water averages about 3 to 5 feet deep. Now we're passing by a red and green building on my right.
Guessing you're
right. Near 5 feet now. That is called the Bocara Hotel. That used to be the L. Frank Saddlery Company. Now, during World War I, they supplied saddles to the French, British, and American Army. By 1918, that was the largest saddlery in the world. Crazy things, like a year ago, we were still riding horses everywhere. Now, on my left is the Omni La Mansion Hotel. This building was built in the mid-1800s. When it opened, it was St. Mary's boarding school for boys. It was the first university in San Antonio. We now have 7 multiple community colleges, a culinary school, art school, and medical school. It's about to get weird. Now, when the building got too small for St. Mary's in the 60s, they moved to the west side of town. Now, of the tower, there is an observation desk, and you can walk all around it. To get to the top, you can take the 952 stairs off where it is a massive underground lake that provides water to San Antonio and the surrounding areas. It later joins the Guadalupe River south of here, and then next is into the Gulf of Mexico. Now, San Antonio is going to utilize the river. Back in the day, in the 1900s, it was 30% of the area they built an irrigation ditch system called the Chequia. Now, the missions were built around this system. We used it for over 200 years, and it was San Antonio's first municipal water system, or the nation's first municipal water system. Now, on my right, as I turn this corner, you're going to see a statue of Saint Anthony de Padua. It's about 8.5 feet tall. Given to us from Portugal. Where St. Anthony is from. Now, does anyone know why Portugal would give San Antonio a statue of St. Anthony? San Antonio, a statue of St. Anthony. We are named after St. Anthony. Reason why? Back in 1691, Father Massenet and a group of Spanish missionaries came to this part of the river. They held mass. The date was June 13th, which is St. Anthony's feast day. So Father Massenet decided to call the river and the surrounding area San Antonio. Now, before the Spanish were here, this area was called Llana Guana. It means place of restful waters. It was named that by the indigenous population that lives here called the Ucayaya. Now, there is archaeological evidence that this area has been inhabited for 12,000 years. On the way was open for the World Fair in 1968. San Antonio had less than 9 months to complete it. The architect, A.T. Zachary, was a graduate of Texas A&M University. He took that challenge. He told San Antonio that if he couldn't complete the building within the time allotted, he would give it to San Antonio for $1 million. It holds the world record for the fastest time for a building of that size to be completed. 202 working days, about 7.5 months. They took the weekend off. Now, how they built it is pretty cool. They built the bottom 4 floors and erected a tower in the center of the tower. Now the rooms were built off site mid south of here, and when they were completely done at 100%, so fully furnished, towels in the bathroom, mints on the pillow, they were brought down here and put stacked on top of each other one by one with a crane. So they look like Legos because they were built Lego style. It's a pretty cool. Now on my left is La Villita. That's Lake 2, Little Village in English. That is San Antonio's first neighborhood. Settled by the Spanish who were stationed at the Alamo in 1722. That is also where Santa Ana had its cannon mine in 1836 during the Battle of the Alamo. We're about a half mile away from the Alamo. So those cannons got pretty close. We're now entering the Artisan River Theater. Completed in 1941, is the only open venue theater in the nation that has a river that goes right through it. On the left can sit up to 800, and on the right is the stage. Now you might recognize the stage from the movie Miss Congeniality. Sandra Bullock and the swimsuit contest were right there. Now above the stage are 5 bells. They represent the 5 Taco Bells here in San Antonio. No, they don't. And I recommend you don't get Taco Bell here. Now, this bridge we're going under right now is named after my great grandmother, Rosita Fernandez. She starred in the summer long music program called Fiesta Noche del Rio for 25 years. She was a pioneer in Tejano music. Lady Bird Johnson calls her San Antonio's first lady of song, and she was in John Wayne's The Alamo. Beginning of the movie, there's like the cantina scene, and she's down on his lap. That's what I'm talking about. On my right, there's a statue of a vaquero taking his long-horned cattle out of the river. They're pointing at me. 4 months later, the Smith and Young brothers lost the building and the $3 million bank investment. Really sucks. Garbage. On a lighter note, Dwight D. Eisenhower had a couple there. Now, straight in front of you, you're going to see a red building. It has a green roof and a beehive-looking dome on the right. That is the Bexar County Courthouse. Bexar spelled B-E-X-A-R. That's how we spelled Bexar here in San Antonio. It is the oldest and longest continuously used courthouse in the state. However, it is San Antonio's fifth seat of power. Before the United States, San Antonio was governed under Spain, Mexico, the Republic of Texas, and the Confederate States. Now, if you look behind me, you're going to get a better view of that Tower Life building. Milam fought in the Battle of Bejar in 1835. Now, Ben Milam was hanging out on my left. He was trying to get to San Fernando, which is now on my right. A Mexican sniper who I recently found out I was related to, which makes this kind of awkward, was hanging out on one of those branches up there and shot Ben Milam right in.
Mira, ya se van, papi.